Highbridge, a division of Recorded Books, presents Please Make Me Pretty, I Don't Want to Die. Poems by Tawanda Mulalu, read by Tawanda Mulalu. Fululama. Let me dance before you, my love. Let me show you the wealth in your house. Hoko, my husband, son of the bull. Let no one uproot the pumpkin. Okotbitek, Song of Lawino. Summer. Argo, my Argo. The mirror's crow-footed, not me. Afro's gone, Medusa again. It recoils its own hydra. I'm adventuring with a comb. The sink's full of myths. The myths are growing. Every day I find myself smaller with effort. My life's light with every person who spoke of me. Last night, Achebe tried again, and I nearly heard him. Nyugi refuses these tones, says, this music has the worst sort of oceans beneath it. Besides, his ears are busy with real myths. Being alive must be nice, says the sink basin, filling further with myths. I say, abandon narrative, latch onto landlocked home, forget ships, take planes, land with passport onto place with shore, forget ships, take planes, land of passport back to place without shore, forget ships for a day sometime on winter break during summer, our only seasons here. My body's a crow-footed boat, not me. One time I went blonde, that's a different prow. One time I went with suit jacket, that's a different sail. One time I go and touch the exact difference. Pretty, sailing, she says, I love you. I say, whose boat? Still life. Onanism, but like coffee without the cream. My skin, yes, but also the pointlessness of our pleasures. In a maple seed shape, we have copper and plastic inside of you. Nothing's growing. I don't finish. So, I'm part of this thing where fish learn to walk. Your first baby pictures look like seahorses. We stop now to consider our lungs. Look at all that we have made, and behold, it is very good. Otherwise, the pale beginnings would swim to nowhere, gasping with gills they do not have once. Before memory, I made this journey and found myself somewhere slapped clean and crying with a new soft bottom. Loneliness. That's one way of seeing it. A palm wet with dyings. Aria. Nigger eye, berries cast dark hooks. Sylvia Plath, Ariel. An aria's any song's sympathy with Ophelia. An aria's any darkness, then any light involved in darkness. Then an aria's like a pool of water. Then an aria's like a painting. Then an aria's like any other sound. When you're sleeping, you sound, and the sound sounds up Karen. And the sound is how I would like to paint Karen's sounds in my darkness. The sound is what I would like to be, like the mirror that Karen sinks into her darkness. mirrors are little darknesses, not unlike my mouth, how I try sounds but find water. I hope someday my mouth finds Karen Carpenter, even if my mouth is not a mirror, it is darkness, even if the mirror is where her skin eats itself like paintings. Your skin's not a painting. It doesn't eat itself, it doesn't eat my skin's darkness, and in darkness, your skin's also darkness. Your bedsheets make a sound, and the sound sounds up Karen's silence again. You wake and consider me. You pass me a bottle of water, and I drink it. Then take the bedsheets as water. Then take the air as water. And now I'm drinking all of you as a painting, which is when I hear horses, hear Sylvia. She's swallowing everything as paintings, and her darkness is a red eye rising as morning's first sound. Then the horse into that red eye is darkness. Then reading a horse into my black eyes is darkness. Then words are sometimes water. Though the flow of sound from each to the next, little sips then swallowing, then with them we paint each other the darkest darkness, and I paint you, hear horses, hear you, Ophelia, Karen, Sylvia, so painting over all of us, and the darkness is painting, and the mirror is every little sipping sound in your room's darkness, and the sounds are everywhere, like skin, like in this darkness, how mine is yours, like any other white girl's, an aria.
Miscegenation Elegy, after Jericho Brown. Let's talk through my window, what it has to do with God. The stars also suffer. Immense and dead, their gases burn distant like castanets of antebellum teeth. My open window, a synecdoche of country. No matter how much smoke a pig roast won't erupt into a song. How its head won't find more careful music than this apple in my mouth. Pardon his sex, this apple erupts into violets. Historians archive our care as an axe upon a ladybird. Air now through my window, what it has to do with Edith strolling away from me. You see, I implant now not only a grandmother, but a garden in your tasteless heart. With just that name and a slant rhyme, Eden, you hear Gaia. Have you heard a person bloom? In that garden, Edith's lips hem. Skyline maintains its mar. The poem required sound from a body. The poem required me to heard by those trees. I gift a woman's voice bottled so cleanly for you. Salted. And coo admiringly with tongue. There are other names. Sogolon. Matavi. Ubume. Lida. Ariel. Hierarchy and how I love. Not violets, no. Implant an ending. Known for representing purity, white flowers are a neutral tone that accents any color. Camellia. Wisteria. Lust. Connecticut. Mornings, his wife could not remember who my face was. Her face stared at me with a mushy smile while Henry ate the same cornflakes with bananas. I watched the yellow flakes uncrisping in his bowl of milk, his gums too soft to bear them. Henry then put me to work on his fields. I don't know who first said it. Probably his teeth cackled fields to his friend who visited him. Limping gently as Henry rolled around in his red tractor.
It roared through his backyard, funneling narrow lanes into the black, hot soil. Waddling after him in my white sneakers, I held blue seeds of grass that pricked my fingers. I tossed them over the soil like a flower girl. "Why are they blue?" I asked him.
"Fertilizer coating," he said.
"Dry mutant rice," said my fizzy mind. Nights, they opened with heavy sweat. He would sit and watch Fox News blare, me next to him, reading a long novel on suffering. But he shouldn't have paid me as a gardener. I dug about as well as a child in a sandbox, shallow, amazed by my skinny handling of that spade. Its crusted rust as dark as my dry skin. No, Henry paid my hands to hold his loneliness, to hear him. I needed a place to stay. He liked to hear me singing off-key in the mornings, taking long, cold showers, and walk down these stairs to him, aging, waiting to plant more blue seeds.
Prayer.
"Move with me," I said to my brain before it startled itself into a mind. I mind myself becoming this person, but without that mind in this world, then there is no world of me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.